Students, now our next topic is the integrated rate equation, right? Now question comes that why is it required? Now you can see here I have written an equation before I start the topic for zero order reactions. A plus B, B gives C, C, D products are formed. Now when we write down the rate equation for it, right, from the rate law, R equals to K, A raised to power P, B raised to power Q. Right, whereas P and Q, they will be experimentally determined. Now students, this expression, right, this one, this is the differential rate equation. Right, now just to get the differential, this is a differential rate equation, and to determine the order of the reaction, right, we have to just solve this, right, and that we do by just plotting a graph and drawing a tangent at a point T, right, and it becomes very inconvenient to solve it out. Now it's better that we just integrate this equation, right? So on integrating the equation, we get a direct relation of the order of the reaction with the experimentally determined quantities, right? That is the concentration terms which we get at the time which we are performing the experiment, right? So we will start with the first with the zero order reaction. So again, it is a differential rate equation. We are going to integrate this equation. So let's begin. So let we have got this is A giving the product. Now here the rate of the reaction will be given by minus dA upon dt equals to K concentration term of A. Now since this is a zero order reaction, so here raised to the power A we will put here zero. So right, so here what we will get now, we are going to express it in this way, dA upon dt, right, equals to minus K in this, so we can just get it one, so it will become minus K dt equals to, this is there, right. Now we will integrate this equation. So integrating on both sides, right students, so here when we integrate it, we get in this way, that is dA equals to minus K dt, right. So here we will get K equals to minus KT plus I. So student, I am putting a constant, which is I is there, the integration constant. Now to get its value, right, let I make it equation 1 here. So we have to obtain the value of I when the time is 0. So when P equals to 0, that time, student, what will be the concentration of A? That will be the initial concentration, right? So now we are going to substitute the value in the equation 1. So what you will get? We get here A naught equals to minus K into 0 plus I. So what is the value of I here? It's A naught. So you will put this value of I equals to A naught in equation 1. So just putting the value of I in equation 1. So you will get A equals to minus KT plus A naught, right? I hope so you have this much is clear. So A equals to minus KT plus A naught. So we are just going to just express or just rearrange this equation. What we will get? We'll get KT equals to A naught minus A. Right, so from here, this one, right, we can just so kT equals to A naught minus A. So from here we can find out the order of the reaction, that will be A naught minus A upon T. So just by knowing the concentration of A naught and initial concentration and the final concentration, right, we can, and this is the time interval for which we want to determine, so we can find out the value of K, that is the rate constant, right, students. Now when we plot a graph, we have got, this is the rate here, right, and this is the concentration. We obtain a straight line. So whenever a graph is plotted, right, a rate on one side and concentration on the other side, we get a straight line obtained, right. So this is for the zero order reaction, where there is rate of the reaction is getting independent of the concentration term. So you can see that with increase in the concentration, there is no effect on the rate of the reaction, right, students. So just plot the graph, right. Now students, we have discussed the graphical representation of the zero order when we just express it through a differential rate law, right. So R equals to minus D upon dt equals to K. This is the differential form of the equation. So here when we plotted the graph, right, between the concentration and the rate, right, we obtained a straight line which indicated that with increase in concentration, the rate of the reaction is not varying, it is remaining constant. So we show that is a zero order reaction, right. Now when we draw the graph or plot the graph for the integrated rate law equation, from the integrated rate law equation, that is concentration of A, final concentration equals to minus kT plus initial concentration, right. So here in this equation, we are just going to compare it with the straight line equation, right. So that is Y equal to mx plus c, and when we plot the graph here, y is coming the concentration term, so we are just having the concentration term on the y-axis, right, and x-axis term we are having the time, so we are just mentioned here on the x-axis the time, right. So when a graph is plotted, since the negative sign is the here, so there will be, we can say the line will be obtained, right. And now when we just I think this is clear, that y equal to mx plus c, we have placed concentration on the y-axis, right, and the time on the x-axis. Why we are drawing the slope in a line negative, we could have drawn in this way also, since it's a negative, minus k is there, right. So we are getting the straight line. When we just extrapolate it, we can get this point, that is the intercept, right, as A naught. To obtain the initial concentration, we will just find out the intercept and we will get the initial concentration, and to obtain the value of K, what we have to find out, the slope. So just by finding the slope of the line, right, we can find out the K, that is the rate constant, right, students. So in this way we can represent the zero order reaction graphically. First rate and the concentration, and second is the concentration versus time plot, right. Yes students, now we will do the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. So it is A giving up the product. So we can write down the first, the differential rate law equation It is in this way. Since it's depending upon the concentration term, it's a first order reaction. So we have placed here one. This is the differential rate equation, rate law equation, right? So this is there. Now we will just extract it upon dt equals to A. So finally, we are going to arrange it in this way, minus dA upon A equals to minus K dt, right? Now we will integrate this equation . So integrating on both sides, what we will get? So it is in this way, dA upon A equals to minus K dt. Students, here we will get ln A, natural log A equals to minus KT plus I. Now again, to obtain the integration constant, we will just assume that at when the time is zero, that time, right, the concentration A will be the initial concentration. I will put the value in this equation. So what we will get here? We'll get here ln A naught equals to minus K into zero plus I. So what we are getting, the value of I, it is ln A naught, right? We'll put the value in equation 1. Putting the value of I in equation 1. So what we are getting? We are getting ln A equals to minus KT plus ln A naught, right? Now next, here we are just getting the concentration term on one side. So we will get minus KT equals to ln A minus ln A naught, or we can write it as KT equals to ln A naught, this minus term will be in logarithm, right? It becomes A naught upon A. Now we are just going to get this thing in term of log term. So it will become now this one, right? So it will become K equals to 2.303. This was ln x, so now it will become 2.303 log A naught upon A, right? So here we had KT, or we can write down that K equals to 2.303 upon T log A naught upon A, right? This is the integrated rate expression for the first order reaction, right? So students, here it is 2.303 T log A naught upon A. Now if A is the initial concentration and X part has been changed into product, then instead of A naught, you will write down A, right? And it will be A minus X at the bottom. So get the thing noted down here. This we have calculated or derived the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction, and this is very important because we are going to solve the numericals based on this equation. Now students will discuss the significance of this integrated rate equation, right? So we got that k equals to 2.303 upon t log a naught upon a. From here we can determine the order of the reaction, right? Here this is the value of the rate constant k, right? From here we can determine the order of the reaction. And how students? Now if we have taken the, if we know the concentration of the reactant, right? We know the concentration of the reactant and the reaction continues, right? With the change in time, right? Time. So we will obtain the different value of K, right? By substituting the known value of the concentration, initial concentration, right? At a particular time. So we will get the concentration of the reactant also, right? And when we will put these value in this equation, we can obtain the order of the reaction. Now if the order of the reaction comes to be constant, it comes to be same, then we will say that it is a first order reaction. So students, for the first order reaction, it has to follow this equation, and the value of K obtained at different time, right, for different value of the concentration of the reactant will be coming same, it will be coming, a constant value will be obtained. Now second is, we can determine the rate constant of a reaction. So we are just using this equation only. We have brought this T here, so becoming KT, 2.303 in the denominator. On the left hand side, we get log A naught upon A. Right, now it is KT upon 2.303 equals to log A naught minus log A. Right, so we will get this equation in the form of Y equal to MX plus C. So where we are taking the log A on the y axis equals to, this is mx and this is c, right? So we will put this log A on the y axis, and this is mx. So this is time here, right students? And we are going to plot the graph. Now since we are getting here minus sign, so the slope, it is going to be in this way, different time interval, right? We are getting the plot here. So when we just extrapolate or extend the graph here with this y intercept, right, will give us the value of log A naught. So from here we will get the value of log A naught. The y intercept will give us the value of log A naught, and the slope of the line will give us the value minus k upon 2.303, right students? So generally what happens that you get in the exam the graphical question, based question also, right? And they will ask you that just see the graph and predict that which order reaction it is, right? Or they will ask you that to write down the integrated rate equation, right, of the order of the reaction, right? And just by seeing the different values of just putting the different values of A naught or and A at a particular time for different time intervals, you will just have to calculate the value of the rate constant. And if its value becomes same, it becoming same for different time, right, it is getting the same value that time, it will be the first order reaction. So students, get this noted down.